expression to the Spirit, give him praise. The Bible says, let the people praise you. Let the people praise you, then the earth will yield an increase. If you believe God that the earth will yield an increase to you, you believe God for increase, then take 1 minute and give him praise. On Facebook, on YouTube, wherever you are connecting from, just go ahead and begin to give him praise. Say, my Father, my God, I worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Because you are the King of Zion. Can you call him beautiful names? Type your name in the chat. Give him a name right now. This is the Lily of the Valley telling. He's the one who is, who was, and who is to come. Call him that name. He's the Rose of Sharon, Emmanuel. I wanted to begin to give him praise, begin to worship him, begin to adore him. Say, Father, I thank you. Father, I worship you. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, Lamb of God. Blessed be your name, Rose of Sharon. Thank you, Jesus. Take 1 minute and begin to worship him. Begin to worship him, my friend. Right now, this is the Lily of the Valley. Lord, I worship you. Thank you. Thank you for who you are, Father. You are just joining right now. Welcome to the Altar of Remembrance. Take this moment and share the link, or somebody share the link and you connected. You also be benevolent enough. Put it on your WhatsApp status. Put it in the groups you belong to so that other people can connect. Because your God is a God that remembers. Go ahead and take one more minute. Take a personal song and begin to worship him. Thank him for who he is. Father, I thank you because you are my healer. Thank you because you are my helper. Thank you because you are my deliverer. Thank you because you are the one that lifted up my head. Thank you because you are the one that changed my story. Thank you because you are the one that defended me. Thank you because you are the one that gave me a new garment. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for answering my enemies with the miracles you are doing in my life. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I adore you. Begin to give him praise for what he will do for you on this altar. Thank him because he's going to answer your prayers. He's going to attend to your issues in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and say, Father, I thank you because you are going to take away my pain. Call him beautiful names. We have 30 more seconds to do that. Call him beautiful names. We have 30 more seconds to do that. Go ahead and worship the living God. Go ahead and worship him. Go ahead and worship him. Go ahead and worship him. The Bible says, he that praises me glorifieth me. Unto him that orders his conversation aright will I show my salvation. All heavens declare the glory of God. The firmament showeth his handiwork. Day unto day utter speech, and night unto night shows knowledge. Can you utter your own speech too? Utter your own speech of thanksgiving. Psalm 100 verse number 4 says, you should enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. The Message version says you should use your password, and that password is thank you. Use your password of praise. Use the password of praise to open the door to your miracle, to open the door to that sign and wonder in the mighty name of Jesus. Go ahead and thank him in advance. Go ahead and thank him in advance. Worship him, my friend. Worship him, my friend. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. My friend, we are at the end of the month. Can you look back 30 days? Look at where you are. Look at where you are. 30 days. See how far God has brought you. See how far. See the provision that has come in, that has come into your hand. See the provision that came into your hand, that came into your bank account. See the healing that you received. See the deliverance that you received. Why don't you give him praise? Why don't you worship him? Why don't you utter your speech? Why don't you utter your speech of thanksgiving? You are just joining us on the altar of remembrance. This is the altar of power, altar of fire, altar of result. Go ahead and give him praise. Father, I thank you for what you would do, because you're going to change my story, because you're going to hear my voice. You're going to put the enemy to shame. You're going to give me fresh encounter, because you are going to inoculate me against the attacks of the enemy. Thank you, because you are going to showcase your faithfulness in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, Rose of Sharon. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Who is like unto you, O God? Glorious in holiness and fearful in praises. Glorious in holiness and fearful in praises. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Go ahead and present yourself before the Lord. Say, my Father, let my voice matter in your presence at this hour. Pray that prayer quickly, my friend. Say, my Father, let my voice matter in your presence. Let my voice matter in your presence. You are going to attend to my issues in the mighty name of Jesus. Quickly pray this prayer. You are just joining us. You are just coming to the altar of remembrance, whether for the first time, whether you have been here before. Go ahead and begin to tell the Lord. Say, my Father, let my voice be heard. Let my voice matter. The Bible says here, he didn't call the sons of Jacob to seek him in vain. He didn't invite you here to seek him in vain. He invited you here for an encounter, for a change, for a transformation. And the God of Israel brought you here for a reason and for a season. May your story change in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We have had the word from the Lord, and that's what we're going to pray about on this altar of remembrance this season. The storm is over. I want someone to begin to declare concerning your life, concerning your family, concerning your marriage, concerning your health, the storm is over. Can someone declare that in the chat prophetically to yourself? The storm is over. Can someone receive it for yourself? The storm is over. Can you receive it in your life, in your ministry? The storm is over. Can you receive it in your story? The storm is over. Say, the storm is over. My friend, my brother, the storm is over. The turbulence is coming to an end. Oh, your change is here. The storm is over. Go ahead and prophesy. Go ahead and declare. Go ahead and receive. Go ahead and announce it to the host of air. Let them know the storm is over. It's over. It's over. It's over. It's over. The storm is over. Declare it, declare it, declare it, my friend, declare it. The storm is over, it's over, it's over, it's over, it's over. The storm is over. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Oh, before we go ahead, I join my faith with you, join my faith with you right there. Everything that represents the storm in your life, in your journey, is over now in the mighty name of Jesus. It's over now in the mighty name of Jesus. Please believe this. Please receive it. It's over now in the mighty name of Jesus. That immigration storm, that marital storm, that physical storm, that financial storm, that storm caused by your enemies, the storm even caused by your own mistake, by your own omission, by your own sins. Oh, the storm is over in the name of Jesus. The storm is over in the mighty name of Jesus. God is handing his peace over to you today in the mighty name of Jesus. And we're going to read that popular scripture you know very well, and that's where you're going to be declaring from. Listen, my friend, pay attention. I want to show you something very important in that scripture. Mark chapter 4 is on your screen. Mark chapter number 4 is on your screen for your convenience. If you have not shared the link, and you have not invited other people, please do it right now so that they can be partakers of what God is doing here. They can partake of what God is doing with us here. Listen, Mark chapter number 4 is right there on your screen. It says, verse 38, he said, and he was in the inner part of the ship. You know the story where Jesus rebuked the storm? But listen to this. Asleep on a pillow. Now, that the storm is raging does not mean the Lord is not with you. The Lord is with you, but he's calm, he's watching, is relaxed, knowing that he's in control. And the Bible says, and they awake him and said unto him, what did they say? Pay attention. What did they say? Master, carest thou not that we perish. They were asking this important question. They said, Master, don't you, these people that were asking, don't forget they are the disciples, don't forget they are believers, don't forget they were not pagans, don't forget they were not Gentiles, don't forget they know the Lord, but they are asking, what is the question you also have been asking? What's the question that have been coming across your mind? What's the question that you have been nursing in your heart? Wondering what is going to happen to you and your family. Wondering what is going to happen to your children. Wondering what is going to happen in your home. Listen, my friend. The question of the disciples is very important for us to consider. What's their question? They are asking. They said, carest not that we perish. That's where we're starting our prayer from. Listen, there are many times you are facing storms, facing opposition, and the question is coming to you that, Lord, do you even know? Do you care? You know the end of the story, so I won't tell you. You know how Jesus rebuked the storm and rebuked the wind, and the thing came to an end. That showed that he cares. That's where we're starting from. There are many attacks of the enemy that will come and making you to question, making you to ask, that does he care? So that's where we are starting from. You are going to be affirming your belief in the Lord once again. That, Father, I know you care about me. Father, I know you are in charge. Father, I know you are in control. This is the question that the disciples were asking. They are asking that, don't you care that we perish? But we knew the end of the story. For you have read it. For you can see it from hindsight. You know that he cares. So you are going to declare, say, Father, I know you care about my situation. Oh, pray. Let him hear you. That's why you are on this altar. That's why they invited you or sent the link to you. That's why you joined, so that you can pray. You may need to even get up from your bed, from your chair, hold your device in your hand and begin to pray. Say, Father, I know you care. I know you care. Like Jeremiah 31:3 says, you say you have loved me with an everlasting love. I know you care about my situation. Say, Father, I know you care about my situation. I know. I refuse to believe that you don't care about me. I reject the lie of the enemy that you don't care about me. I reject the lie of the enemy that you don't care about me. I know you care. Father, I know you are in charge. Say, in the name of Jesus, I know you care. I have seen the proof. I have read it. I see that you are in control. That's your affirmation. Begin to pray. Say, my Father, I have read it. I believe your word. I know you are in control. The enemy wants me to believe you are not in control. The enemy wants to make me think I will perish. The enemy wants me to think that things have gone haywire and there's no way out. The enemy thought that I am in a tight, the enemy is making me to think I'm in a tight corner. I refuse the lie of the enemy. Somebody declare it. Say, I refuse the lie of the enemy. The lie of the enemy that you will not be healed. The lie of the enemy that you won't get your papers. The lie of the enemy that you won't get a job. The lie of the enemy that you won't buy that house. The lie of the enemy that you won't grow up old. The lie of the enemy that you will die untimely. I want everyone on this line, for the next 1 minute, begin to reject every lie of the enemy. Say, in the name of Jesus, the lie of the enemy that you don't care for me, the lie of the enemy that I will die in this storm, the lie of the enemy that there is no future for me, the lie of the enemy that I will never be married, the lie of the enemy that I won't have gainful employment, I reject it. You're on Facebook, you're on YouTube, wherever you're connecting from, say, I reject it. Somebody reject it. Somebody type it in the chat. Say, I reject it. Somebody speak it loud and clear to your God. Say, I reject it. Say, I reject it. I know you care. I reject the lie of the enemy. This was the question of the disciples. This was their concern. That's what they are thinking about. Carest not that we perish. These were the disciples. These were the ordained people. It gets to a time that a child of God, sometimes you are wondering. I'm here to reassure you today. And I want you to pray yourself into reassurance. Say, Father, I know you are in charge. Father, I know you are working on the ground. I know you are arranging my papers. I know you are working out my miracle. I know you are working out my testimony. I know you are in charge. I reject the lie of the enemy. I reject the lie. That spirit speaking to me that I won't make it. Get out. Can you rebuke that spirit of fear? Can you rebuke that spirit of fear. Like this video and say, I reject it. Somebody type it, say, I reject it. Somebody utter it out, say, I reject the voice of the enemy. I reject the voice of the enemy. The same enemy that came to Eve in the garden, he said, did God indeed say? Did he really say? He's questioning your God. He's questioning the grace of God upon your life. Oh, say in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, you care for me. I know you care for me. I know you care for me. I know you are in control. I know you are in charge. I know this storm is over. I know I will make it. I know I will see the end of the road. I know I will get to the end of it. I know I will get this degree. I know I will get this paper. I know I will be approved. I know I will be interviewed. I know I will be employed. Begin to speak it. Begin to speak it. Begin to speak it. Say, I know you are in charge. I know you are in charge. My Father, you are in charge. In the name of Jesus, I reject the lie of the enemy. I reject the lie of the enemy. I have seen the proof. I have read it in the scripture. I can see from hindsight that you care. It may look like as if you are sleeping, but I know that you care. I know that you care. I know you will see me through. These my children that I'm concerned about, I know they will make it. I reject the lie of the enemy that they will not make it. I reject the lie of the enemy that they will not be settled. I reject the lie of the enemy that I will be poor. I reject the lie of the enemy that I won't get those papers. I reject the lie of the enemy that I will not be employed. In the name of Jesus, I know you care, my Father. You care. You care for me. You care for me. You care for me. Your word has said it. You said you love me with an everlasting love. Your word told me I'm the apple of your eyes. Your word told me that I'm a God myself. Your word told me I'm a heir of salvation. I refuse the lie of the enemy. I reject the lie of the enemy. Satan, leave me alone. Satan, leave me alone. Satan, leave me alone. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for you, my friend, that you are connecting by faith right now. You are hearing the sound of my voice wherever you are connecting from. I pray that in the name of Jesus, before this month end, you will see a sign that God cares for you. Oh, I join my faith with somebody that is saying amen. Oh, these few hours left in this month, you will see a sign that God cares for you. In the name of Jesus, let somebody receive that for themselves. Let them somebody say amen to that. You will see a sign that God cares for you. We are still praying. I like you to be militant with this prayer. I like you not to waste your time, your data, wherever you are connecting from. Pay attention to these scriptures. Listen, that storm is over. That challenge is over. That trouble is over. The lie of the enemy is gone forever. In the name of Jesus, you will receive your miracle. You will embrace your miracle. Your miracle will be evident in the mighty name of Jesus. Look at that scripture. We are still reading it again. I'm going to read it again. Pay attention. I put it on your screen for your convenience. Listen, the Bible says, and he was at the back of the ship. What was he doing? Sleeping on a pillow. Many times you are wondering, why is God just folding his hands? You are wondering, God, you are watching me. When will I be married? Oh, I was 25, I was praying. I was 30, I was praying. Now I'm 35. Are you sure I will still be married? Now you are asleep. And the Bible was even clear to say he was asleep on a pillow. Why did they need to put pillow there? They could have just said he was sleeping. But they gave us that picture. They wanted you to see how calm your God is. They wanted you to see how much in charge of your situation he is. That he's not disturbed like you are disturbed. He's not disturbed. He's not troubled like you are troubled. And they now woke him. They had to wake him. Oga, please wake up, wake up, wake up. What did they say to him? Master, don't you care that we perish? We have prayed it, we have settled it in our heart that he cares for us. But you want to declare now, you and I, don't forget, I'm inviting you to pray this scripture from hindsight. What the disciple did not know that time, you know it today. Eventually, you saw how he rebuked the wind, how he stopped the wind, how eventually they crossed over. You saw that he cares. But at this moment, these guys, they were thinking that they will perish. Are you also thinking that you will perish? Are you also thinking this storm will swallow you up? Are you also thinking you will make it out? pastor is preaching, they are prophesying, but at the side of, at one corner in your mind, you are wondering, will I ever make it? Will I ever get it? Today, you want to pray yourself into believing it again. You want to tell the enemy that things will work out for you. You want to shout it on top of your voice again. Say, my Father, I will not perish in this storm. Raise your voice and pray this prayer. I beg you, don't waste your time on this platform. Don't just waste your time and come and say, oh, let me go and see how this Pastor Shane Jonathan can lead prayers. No, don't start just, oh, I'm here to count how many people are there. No. Pray militantly. The Bible says they were asking, careless not that we perish, but we saw eventually that they did not perish. So you too will pray that prayer. Say, my Father, I will not perish in this storm. I will make it to the other side. Your prayer is very simple. Raise your voice. Say, my Father, I will not perish in this storm. I will make it to the other side. My Father, raise your voice. Say, my Father, raise your voice. Say, my Father, I will not perish in this storm. I will make it to the other side. Say, I will make it to the other side. I will make it to the other side. I will make it to the other side. Say, in the name of Jesus, this marital storm, I will not perish in it. This financial storm, I won't perish in it. I will not perish in this storm because my God is in control. My God is in control. I will see the end of this turbulence. I will see the end. Say, I will see the end of this trouble. Somebody mentioned that issue. Say, I will see the end of this issue. Oh, Gabaro Bagaduzo Brekatakalagadaboshokata. If Ranekato Kataya, oh, this arthritis, I will see the end of it. This monthly pain, I will see the end of it. This huge debt that I have in the bank, I will see the end of it. In the name of Jesus, this trouble that I cannot explain, I will see the end of it. I will be on the other side. I will not perish in this storm. I will cross over to the other side. I will not perish in this storm. I will make it to the other side. My Father, somebody raise your voice and pray this prayer. Join me, pray this prayer. It's just few minutes we have together. Make maximum use of it, my friend. Make maximum use of it. Open your mouth. Open it, open it, open it. Articulate this prayer. Don't pray the prayer in your mind, my friend, don't pray it in your mind. Say it out. Say, in the name of Jesus, I will not perish in this storm, this academic storm. Oh, my whole academic life is thwarted. I don't even know which way to go again. I will not perish in it. I will make it to the other side. Oh, Sheun Jonathan will make it to the other side. Oh, Maruso Fradita Haya Gadagada. Embrodi Kentu Sofradata. Ekato Yabalabalaba. I will make it to the other side. Oh, they say, Karen, not that we perish. We, you and I know they didn't perish. You also will not perish. You also will not perish. You will make it to the other side. You will make it to the other side. You will make it to the other side. Say, in the name of Jesus, my Father, I will not perish in this situation. I will not perish. I will not give up. In the name of Jesus, say, I declare, I will make it to the other side. Oh, my family will make it to the other side. My spouse will make it to the other side. In the name of Jesus. Things will work out for me. Somebody type it. Say, things will work out for me. Somebody receive it. Say, things will work out for me. Somebody type it. Things will work out for me. Somebody receive it. Things will work out for me. Somebody type it. Things will work out for me. It's working out for you. It's working out for you. It's working out for you. It's working out for your family. It's working out for your family. It's working out for you. It's working out for you. Is working out for you. Things are working. Things are working. Somebody receive it. Say, things are working. Things are working. Somebody receive it. Things are working. That applications are is working. Oh, Maru, things are working. Things will work out for you. In the name of Jesus, things will work out for you. In the name of Jesus, things will work out for you. You will see the end of the storm in the mighty name of Jesus. You will see the end of the storm in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Listen, my friend, you are just joining now. Things are working out for you. You will see the end of the storm in the name of Jesus. The storm will not see the end of you in the mighty name of Jesus. I want somebody to pray. Pray. You are going to raise your voice now. Say, my Father, say, favorable wind. wind begin to blow towards me in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout, say favorable wind. Oh, things is working out for somebody. Things is working out for you. Oh, things are working out for Sheun Jonathan. 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 Things are working out for, use your name, use your name, use your name, use your name, use your name. Things are working out for Sheun Jonathan. Things are working out for Sheun Jonathan in the name of Jesus. Raise your voice, my friend. Say favorable wind blow towards me in the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody shouted, say favorable wind. Oh, let it be louder than that. Your God can hear you. Don't pray this prayer in your mind. I'm begging you. This is not a prayer of the mind. This is a prayer you open your mouth, articulate it. Let it come. Let it come out. Let it come out. Let it come out. Give an expression to the spirit. Say favorable wind blow in my direction. Favorable wind blow in my direction. I will end this month on a good note. Favorable wind begin to blow in my direction. Begin to blow in my direction. Begin to blow over my family. Begin to blow over my family. Begin to blow over my life. Begin to blow over my situation. Begin to blow where I've made an application. Favorable wind blow over the people deciding over my issue. Favorable wind blow over the people deciding my issue. Favorable wind blow in my womb so that I can be pregnant. Favorable wind blow so that my husband can locate me. Favorable wind blow so that things can change for me. Favorable wind blow so that they can grant that visa. Favorable wind blow. Favorable wind blow. Favorable wind blow. My friend, say it's not too much for you to say it. Open your mouth, don't say it in your mind, say it out. Say favorable wind blow in my direction. Blow on this prayer altar. Blow on this altar of remembrance. Blow over my ministry. Blow over the church I pastor. Blow over the members of my church. Blow over my family. Blow. Favorable wind blow in the name of Jesus. Favorable wind begin to blow in the name of Jesus. It's blowing over your family. My friend, if you have not shared this link, you are not doing well at all. If you have not take a moment as you are praying that prayer, share the link quickly. Share it. Put it on your status. Put it in a group. Share it, please. On YouTube, share, like the video and share quickly. Share it. Take 30 seconds to share this thing so that before we conclude, so other people can be beneficiary of this prayer line. Please share it now, so that other people, favorable wind are blowing. My friend, share it. You too, share it. Go ahead, share it, so that other people can be part of this thing. Favorable wind is blowing. Instead of the storm, favorable wind. Favor, share the link quickly. If you have not, like the video and share. Don't forget, you have a prayer request. You know the email right below the video, on YouTube. You have a testimony from previous episode. Send it in. Prayer request, send it in. Testimony, send it in. Favorable wind is blowing. You will testify in the name of Jesus. You will testify in the name of Jesus. People will ask for your number to hear your testimony. People will ask for your number to be able to hear your testimony in the name of Jesus. Favorable wind will blow. It will blow. It will blow in the name of Jesus. It will blow. It will blow. Favorable wind is blowing. It's blowing. It's blowing. It's blowing. Things are working for you. Things are working for you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. I pray for someone. Instead of the turbulent storm, instead of the storm that consumes, favorable wind will blow. I pray for someone. Instead of the storm that consumes, favorable wind will blow. In Jesus' name we pray. Shout a threefold amen. Loud and clear. Amen. 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 In the name of Jesus. Listen, my friend. I pray that situation you have found yourself, favorable wind will blow to remove you, to bring you out in the name of Jesus. I pray for someone on the line right now. I'm hearing in my spirit some people ganged up against you. You're on this line hearing me right now. Some people ganged up against you. The Lord is saying, as you step into the new month, the wind will blow and the secret will be open. Oh, I'm saying it again. Some people ganked up against you as you step into the new month. The Lord is saying the wind will blow and the secret will be open. The wind will blow and the secret will be clear. I pray in the name of Jesus, you are coming out. Out of that tight corner, you are coming out in the name of Jesus. You are coming out in the name of somebody. Shout it. I am coming out. Somebody receive it. I am coming out. Somebody receive it. I am coming out. Somebody receive it. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. You are just joining in. Maybe they just share the link. Listen, the Lord is telling us the storm is over. That stormy sea in your life is over. That storm is over. The storm in your finances, over your job, over your ministry, over your family is over now. In the name of Jesus, favorable wind is blowing towards your life. You are just connecting now. As you are connecting, favorable wind is blowing over your home. Favorable wind blowing over your bank account. Favorable wind blowing over your ministry. Favorable wind blowing over your home. There is someone, there is a pain in the neck that has been persistent for so long. As we are praying right now, that pain is disappearing now because favorable wind is blowing. Favorable wind is blowing, is blowing, is blowing, is blowing. In the name of Jesus, you are coming out of that trouble, coming out of that stormy sea, coming out of that limitation. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Pay attention now. You know the story when this guy was locked up in prison. Acts chapter 16 verse 26. It was as if there was no way to come out. But the Bible says suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prisons were shaking. How come was there an earthquake? Why did the foundation begin to shake? It's because favorable wind was blowing. Because a son of God must come out. Because a child of God must come out. So the favorable wind began to blow. The favorable wind began to blow. The same way it's blowing for you, the same way it's going to blow for you. The Bible says suddenly there was a great earthquake and the foundation of the prison was shaken. And immediately, somebody shout immediately. That's what is happening to you, my friend. All the doors were open. All the doors were open. And everyone's bounce. Well, fasting. I pray in the name of Jesus, the wind that will set you free blowing over you now. The wind that will shake the foundation of your trouble, blow over you now. In the name of Jesus, blow over you now. In the name of Jesus, blow over you now. Blow over you now. Blow over you now. Blow over you now. In the name of Jesus, you are coming out. Somebody receive it in the name of Jesus. You are coming out. Your story is changing and you are handling your results in your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. Listen, let's go back to our story that we're using to pray. The Bible says they were asking a question. Don't you care that we perish? And I know, you and I know that you are not going to perish in that storm. You and I know that your God cares about your situation. You and I know your God is in control. You and I know God is working on your behalf. And eventually the testimony is coming out. And eventually you are going to receive it in the name of Jesus. Listen, that's chapter 4 that we are reading. The Bible says there, by the time you move to verse number 40, let's read together, it's on your screen. And he said to them, why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? This was after he solved their problem. He now went back to them. He now asked them that, why are you fearful? How is it that you have no faith? My friend, that attack of the enemy in your life is an attack on your faith. The stormy sea that you are facing right now is so that your faith will be attacked. The enemy that is trying to lie to you is so that once he takes your faith away from you, you have lost everything. May you not lose in the name of Jesus. I say it again, may you not lose in the name of Jesus. So you are going to pray now. My faith will not be attacked. My faith will not be attacked. The Lord told them, he said, why are you so fearful? Why are you so afraid? How is it that you have no faith? You are going to pray. Say, my faith will not be attacked. That is the instrument you need to get your miracle. That is the instrument you need to get your sign and your wonder. Say, in the name of Jesus, my faith will not be attacked. I will not miss it. I will not compromise. I will not give up. I will not reduce my goal and my vision. I will not change my mind over what God can do. In the name of Jesus, my faith will not be attacked. You have been waiting on God, waiting on God, and waiting on God, and you are tired. Like the psalmist said, he said, how long, Psalm 13, and how long will you forsake us? You are going to pray. Say, my Father, my faith will not be attacked. I want you to pray and strengthen yourself in the presence of the Lord now. Say, in the name of Jesus, my faith will not be attacked. My faith will not be attacked. In the name of Jesus, I will see the end of this challenge. I will see the end of this storm. The storm is over. My faith will not be attacked in the name of Jesus. Father, strengthen my faith. Father, strengthen my faith. Strengthen my faith. Strengthen my faith. Strengthen my faith. My faith will not be attacked. The Lord asked them a question. It was so clear. Look at it again on your screen. He said to them, why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? Can you to begin to come against the spirit of fear? Rebuke the spirit of fear. Rebuke the spirit of fear. Rebuke the spirit of fear. I will not lose my faith. I will not lose my faith. I will not lose my faith in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, look at your screen, for this cause we faint not. 2 Corinthians 4:16, for this cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day. Though it looks as if, oh, don't you care that we perish? It looks as if I want to perish, but my inward man is renewed day by day. Say, for this cause I faint not. Can you begin to pray? I will not faint. I will not give up. I will not give up. I will not doubt in the name of Jesus. I will not doubt. I will not doubt what the Lord can do. I will not doubt what the Lord can do. My faith will not be attacked in the name of Jesus. My faith will not be attacked in Jesus' name we pray. I pray for everyone on the line. Your faith will not be attacked. You will not be fearful. You will not lose hope in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want you to raise your voice and pray. Don't forget, we are praying about the storm is over. Begin to pray. Say, every persistent problem. Raise your voice. Say, every persistent problem. Every annual storm, regular affliction, monthly pain. Oh, I disrupt your programming in my life. Say, in the name of Jesus. Oh, that's why you join the line, so that you can pray. Say, every persistent problem, annual pain, regular storms, monthly affliction, oh, that the enemy has planned for me, I disrupt your programming by fire. I disrupt your programming by fire in the name of Jesus. The pain that the enemy has planned for you again for next month, he wants you to repeat that trouble again next month. Say, in the name of Jesus. Say, in the name of Jesus. Say, in the name of Jesus, I disrupt your programming. In the mighty name of Jesus, I disrupt that programming for woe. Every program of woe, every program of delay, every program of trouble. In the name of Jesus, oh maruba kata yaba loko sotaya ibrenia kato suparobate makilaba kato suparashete ebrande keto koso kataya ibragala bagando suprekete epashe kato sakata rugendi keto suparubakata imbrakato shepalakata. Every storm that has been programmed for me by the enemy, storm that has been programmed for me, I disrupt it. I disrupt the programming. Jesus' name we pray. You know, eventually, what the Lord do? The Bible says, what did your God do? What did he do eventually? He arose and rebuked the wind. He arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, peace, be still. And what happened? The wind ceased, and there was a great calm. There was a great calm. There was a great calm. Say, in the name of Jesus, oh, baki paruta handaha. Oh, peace, be still. Somebody begin to shout it. Peace, be still. Somebody begin to echo it. Peace, be still. You know your issue. You know where the shoe pinches. You know the trouble. You know the issue of concern. Say, in the name of Jesus, peace, be still. Peace, be still. Peace, be still. Over my life, peace, be still. Over this challenge, peace be still. Oh, over my issues, peace be still in the name of Jesus. Over that storm, peace be still. Stretch your right hand like I'm doing my own right now. Say in the name of Jesus, peace be still. Raise your voice. Say, peace be still. 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 That bad dreams you keep having, oppression in the dream every night, peace be still. Peace be still. Peace be still. That fearful spirit, peace be still. That legal trouble you have found yourself, peace be still. That financial storm, peace be still. In the name of Jesus, so it will be for you and your family. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Shout a threefold amen, my friend. Shout a threefold amen, my friend. Amen. 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 In the name of Jesus, I like somebody to raise their voice by the reason of your testimony that is coming. Say, Lord, use my lifting to reply my enemies. Oh, somebody raise your voice. Say, Lord, use my lifting to reply my enemy. The enemies that have been wondering, where is my God? The enemy that has been wondering, what's the result of this thing that you are saying? I'm serving God. Say, my Father, use my lifting to reply my enemy. This month will end on a good note for me. This month will end on a good note for me. This month will end on a good note for me. This month will end on a good note for me. Say, my Father, my Father, my Father, my Father, use my lifting to lift, to reply my enemy. Use my lifting to reply my enemy. Use my lifting to reply my enemy. Use my lifting to reply my enemy. Things are changing for you. Things are working for you. Your story is changing. God is hearing your voice. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name we pray. You will have something to celebrate. You will have something to celebrate. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I'm going to take a prayer request right now. I want to thank the person that just joined us as ministry partner on this YouTube. Everyone on the line, if you can also, you can become a member by clicking join and supporting the ministry. The hand of the Lord will be upon you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Muna Jesus Love, that just became a partner there. I'm going to take this prayer request. Please pay attention, and I want you to pray and also receive it for yourself. Someone is sending a request. He said, my husband went to American Embassy to collect his citizenship, but he was told to bring a document. And we replied, and they said they will get back to us. They've not get back to them yet. We want to speak a word that in the name of Jesus, that there will be speedy results. In the name of Jesus, speedy results. I declare over that family, declare over that man, over that woman, over that person that is trying to get their citizenship, that in the mighty name of Jesus, receive speedy answer, speedy result. In the name of Jesus, I pray God will buy time for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, speedy result. Everything that is an inhibition, everything that is a limitation is removed now. Somebody begin to pray. Say, every limitation, every barrier between me and my result be removed. Someone on the line, join me to pray. Say, every barrier between me and my result be removed. Somebody declare, every barrier between me and my result be removed. Barrier of people, barrier of policies, barrier of COVID issue, or barrier of office closure, or every barrier between me and my result be removed. Every barrier. Take 1 minute and pray. Say in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout it. Say, be removed. Somebody type it in the chat on Facebook, YouTube. Say, be removed in Jesus' name. Barriers, be removed in the name of Jesus. Demonic barrier, be removed in the name of Jesus. Barriers, be removed in the name of Jesus. Barriers, be removed in the name of Jesus. Barriers, be removed in the name of Jesus. Be removed in the mighty name of Jesus. Be removed in the mighty name of Jesus. The barrier is removed. The barrier that is not allowing you to be pregnant, is removed in the name of Jesus. That near success syndrome spirit, the spirit of near success syndrome, that barrier is removed. You already saw the result ahead, but you can't undo it. You saw the result ahead, you can't undo it. The barrier is removed. The barrier is removed in the name of Jesus. The barrier is removed in the mighty name of Jesus. The barrier is removed. You'll be able to embrace your miracle. You'll be able to touch your miracle. You will touch that citizenship. You will touch that visa. You will touch that job offer. You will touch that good news. You will touch it in the name of Jesus. You will touch that pregnancy. In the mighty name of Jesus, the barrier is removed. A Jordan will pathway for you, and you will testify. In the name of Jesus, I say Jordan will pathway for you, and you will testify. I confront every spirit standing in your way. Barriers be removed. Somebody shout again. Say barrier be removed. Say barrier be removed. I will not be denied of my testimony. Somebody shout it there. I will not be denied of my testimony. Somebody type it there. I will not be denied of my testimony. Somebody shout it there. I will not be denied of my testimony. I will not be denied of a good marital life. I will not be denied of having children. I will not be denied of having a good job. I will not be denied of answered prayer. I will not be denied of flourishing ministry. I will not be denied. I will not be denied. On Facebook, on YouTube, receive it. Receive it over the application that you have made. I will not be denied. I refuse negative report. I refuse negative report. I will not be denied. In the mighty name of Jesus, that barrier is removed. That obstacle is removed. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. If you're just joining us, we're about rounding off. The storm is over in your life. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. One of the testimonies we received, you can see it pinned in the chart here on top. He said last week, the man of God said we will testify, and indeed I would like to testify that I received my citizenship on Thursday. Praise God. I am praying for someone that is here, that as you are congratulating this person, as you are saying amen to this, that your testimony is coming in the name of Jesus. You will undo your testimony. This month we end with your testimony. This month we end with the visibility of your testimony. I declare with you, I declare over your life, this month we end with the visibility of your testimony. This month we end with the visibility of your testimony in the name of Jesus. Somebody begin to pray. Say, this month we end on a good note for me and my family. This month we end on a good note for me and my family. Somebody say it again. This month we end on a good note for me and my family. The new month will bring results in my life in the mighty name of Jesus. The new month will bring testimony for me in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody begin to declare now, I will not suffer evil. As I cross over into the new month, I am exempted from the trouble therein. I am exempted from the trouble surrounding. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am exempted. Claim your exemption. Exemption from trouble. Exemption that, and he also made it. He almost made October. I claim my exemption. Look at your screen. The Bible says, Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 17, the Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. When your God is in the midst of you, that storm will come. When the Lord God of Israel is with you, the storm will come. He said, the Lord thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. He will serve. He will rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love. He will joy over thee with singing. The Lord your God in the midst of thee is mighty. You will not suffer evil because the Lord is with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not lose anything. In the mighty name of Jesus, nothing will be missing, nothing will be broken. The hand of the Lord will be upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray again. In the name of Jesus, this month we end on a good note for me and my family. I'm free from bitterness and pain. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will fight for you, and you will hold your peace. In the mighty name of Jesus, I want to begin to give God praise now. Thank him, because the storm is over. Say, thank him. Father, I thank you. Because the storm is over. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus. As you transit into the new month, that Egyptian you see before, you see it no more. The Egyptian that you saw so far, you will see it no more. In the mighty name of Jesus. As you transit into the new month, listen, my friend, Isaiah 52 verse 12 on your screen. Say, for you shall not go out with haste, nor go by flight, for the Lord will go before Shaul Jonathan, and the God of Israel will be your rear guard. Picture that. That means the Lord is in front of you and is at your rear. The Lord is in front of you, is at your rear. The previous scripture I read, the Lord is in the midst of you. If the Lord is in the midst of you, he's also in the front of you, he's also at your rear. Nothing missing, nothing broken. No evil can come towards you in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray this month we end on a good note for you and your family. I declare again, this month we end on a good note for you and your family in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to give God praise. Say, Father, I thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Because this month we end on a good note for me and my family. I'm free from pain, free from bitterness in the mighty name of Jesus. This month we end on a good note for me and my family in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want you to join your faith with me. The Lord sent me on this platform. I didn't send myself. As I declare over every one of us, I want, if you are sitting down, you are lying down, please try. If you can just stand up and carry your device in your hand, just for these few minutes as I make the final declaration. I declare the barrier between your miracle is removed and you are coming back with your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. You are coming back with your celebration. You are coming back with your good news of ha in the name of Jesus. I speak the word in the name of Jesus right now. Father, I thank you. Thank you because you are the God of Israel. El Elohi of Israel. The King of Zion. We worship you. Blessed be your name. You are the one that sits upon the circles of the earth. Thank you for gathering us together. There is a man that can pray. There is a God that can answer. And you are that God. We are confident. We believe. We rely on you. We rely on your capacity, on your ability. We worship you, Jesus. Father, we come before you. We ask that in the name of Jesus, you, God of Israel, come and attend to our storms. Everyone on the line saying amen. I pray the storm is over. Everyone shouting amen. That storm is over. That pain in the leg, the storm is over. Your health condition, the storm is over. In your family, your home, the storm is over. Over your business, your children, the storm is over. Everything pertaining to your life and destiny, the storm is over. I declare that in the name of Jesus, so you will not perish in that storm. You will see the end of that storm. You will cross over to the other side. When the storm comes, it's a sign that there is a good thing on the other side. When the storm came against Jesus, it's because there was a man to be delivered on the other side. I pray right now in the name of the Father, the Son of the Holy Spirit, whatever is on the other side, you will see it. The reason why the host of hell came against you so that you will not be able to see, I pray this storm is coming now. You will cross over. You will cross over. You will cross over. You will cross over into good news. You will cross over into testimony. You will cross over into your citizenship. You will cross over into your marital destiny. You will cross over into your marital destiny. You cross over, you cross over, you cross over into fruitfulness to carry your twins in your hand, to carry your triplets in your hand. You cross over into a new anointing of the Holy Ghost. You cross over, you cross over the threshold that the enemy has put upon you, the limitation, the barrier, the capping, the embargo the enemy has laid upon you. You will cross over to the other side, 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 to the other side. Oh, the people asked, they said, Master, carest not that we perish? We know that God cares. I pray for everyone on the line. Before the end of this month, the remaining few hours in this month, you will see a sign that God cares. Oh, God will show you a token that He cares. God will show you a sign that you care. He cares. In the name of Jesus, He will show you a token. He will show you a sign. You will see it by credit alert. You will see it by healing in your body. You will see it by phone calls. You will hear it by emails. God will show you a token. You will hear it by approval in the name of Jesus. He will show you a token that He cares. In the name of Jesus, I reject the lie of the enemy that is speaking to you that He doesn't care. He's speaking to you that your God is sleeping on a pillow. He's speaking to you that you will perish in that storm. I come against that spirit. I reject that lie of the enemy in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Oh, the Lord in the midst of you is mighty. God will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus. God will show up for you in the mighty name of Jesus. God will show up for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord will lift you as a reply to your enemy. The God will use your lifting to reply your enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus, He will use your lifting to reply your enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare over everyone on the line now, let favor every wind begin to blow, begin to blow, begin to blow in your family, begin to blow in your home, begin to blow on your health, begin to blow over your internal organs that needs healing. Let the favorable wind begin to blow over that contract, over that your request. You are submitting that request. You are making that application. Favorable wind. Favorable wind. Favorable wind. Favorable wind. In the name of Jesus, I pray that every evil that is laid out, every program of woe, of delay, oh, monthly pain, annual affliction that is programmed, oh, you are exempted from it in the name of Jesus. You are exempted from it in the name of Jesus. You are exempted from it in the name of Jesus. You will not lose anything. You will not sorrow. You will not sorrow in the mighty name of Jesus. You have something to celebrate. You have something to celebrate. And I declare this month will end on a good note for you and your family. Your faith will not be attacked. Your faith will not be attacked. You will not reduce your vision and your goals. You will continue to believe in your God. And that storm will come. The storm will come in the mighty name of Jesus. Because your God is in control. In the name of Jesus, I join my faith with you. As a man of God sent on this platform, you will end this month with a testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. And your story will end in glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Shout a sevenfold amen. 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 In the name of Jesus. Give God praise for 1 minute. Thank Him because you have